Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss polynomial and synthetic division. Let's start with an example of synthetic division. The example says to divide 2x cubed plus x squared plus 4 by x minus 1 using synthetic division. Let's work through it. Solution. So synthetic division only works when you're dividing by something like x minus c or x plus c. In this particular case, we're dividing by x minus 1, so all is okay. First step in synthetic division is to take this number down here, this negative 1, and change the sign. So because it's a negative 1, we're going to write a 1. I'm going to put a little bracket like this. So if this was x plus 1, then you would put a negative 1 here. So you just flip the sign. The next thing you want to do is you want to write down the coefficients of the numerator. So it'll be 2, the next one is 1, and then you'll notice that there's a power of x missing, so you want to fill in that power of x. So you want to write it as 0x, because it's not really there, so you need to put a 0 here. So very important to add any missing powers of x with zeros. And then you have the 4. And then you draw a line like this. So recap. All you do is you switch the sign here on the bottom, then you write down the coefficients, 2, 1, 0, and then 4. Don't forget the 0, so you have to have all powers of x. And here we start the process. I'm going to change colors for this step. So the first step is to take this number and just bring it down. So you just write it down, so 2, boom, there it is. So just bring it down. And then you start the multiplication process. 2 times 1 is 2. And then you add 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 times 1 is 3. And then you add 0 plus 3 is 3. 3 times 1 is 3. And then you add 4 plus 3 is 7. And then you put a little bracket here to identify that this is actually your remainder. Let's do it again. Bring down the 2. 2 times 1 is 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 times 1 is 3. 0 plus 3 is 3. 3 times 1 is 3. 4 plus 3 is 7. So now what you do is you write your answer down. Basically, you look at these coefficients. So because this is degree 3, it's cubic, you start at 1 less. So you're going to start at 2. So it'll be 2 times x to the 2. This 2 is from the 3. It's 1 less. Plus, then you just go down in order. 3x plus 3. See how the powers are decreasing? Coefficients are 2, 3, 3. And then it's x squared, x, and then no x. Then you put a plus sign, then you take your 7, and you put it over x minus 1, your divisor. And that would be the answer using synthetic division. So pretty cool. Let's go ahead and do an example of polynomial long division, which is a little bit more challenging than this. Divide 2x cubed minus 5x squared minus x plus 1 over 2x plus 1 using long division. Let's go ahead and carefully work through this example solution. So you start by writing down the piece that's on the bottom on the outside like this, 2x plus 1. Then you write this symbol. And then the piece that's up top goes inside here. So it's 2x cubed minus 5x squared minus x plus 1. If you're missing powers of x, then you would put in like a 0x, but we're not missing any powers of x or anything, so all is good. Now you ask the question, what do you multiply by 2x in order to get 2x cubed? Well, x squared. So you put it above the x squared term. And you should check, because x squared times 2x is 2x cubed, so it does work. And now you actually do that. You perform the multiplication. X squared times 2x is 2x cubed. X squared times 1 is x squared. Then you draw a line, and then you're supposed to subtract. Some people change the signs. What I do is I put parentheses and a big minus sign, and I add. So 2x cubed plus a negative 2x cubed is 0. Negative 5x squared minus x squared is minus 6x squared. And then you bring down the next term, a minus x. And then you ask the question again. What do you multiply by 2x in order to get negative 6x squared? Well, minus 3x. Then you multiply. Minus 3x times 2x is minus 6x squared. Minus 3x times 1 is minus 3x. You draw a line. I'm going to put parentheses, a big minus sign, and add. Negative 6x squared plus 6x squared is 0. Negative x plus 3x is 2x. Very easy to mess up there, right? Got to be really careful. Then you bring down the 1. And we do it again. What do we multiply by 2x to get 2x? 1. Then you multiply. 1 times 2x is 2x. 1 times 1 is 1. Look at that. We're going to get 0. It's really cool. Now we can write our answer down. The answer is always going to be the quotient, which is up here. So it's x squared. This is the quotient. X squared minus 3x plus 1 plus the remainder, which is 0, over the divisor, which is 2x plus 1. So this last piece is 0. You don't really have to write it, but I wanted to write it to show you that the answer always has that form. It's always quotient plus remainder over divisor. Sometimes people ask you for the individual pieces. So if someone said, hey, what's the remainder? You would say 0. They said, hey, what's the divisor? You would say 2x plus 1. And if someone asked you what the quotient was, it would be x squared minus 3x plus 1. Long division takes a lot of practice and patience. Hopefully this video has been helpful to you. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.